Welcome to Lakewood United Methodist Church, and happy Father's Day to all of our dads. The flowers this morning are on the altar, given to the glory of God by Robert Yates in memory of his dad, Jeffrey Yates. Thank you, Robert, for sharing the flowers. We do have gifts for all of our dads who are worshiping in person. You're watching this on YouTube, so obviously you're not here, but I'm sure there will be many of these gifts still remaining. So if you'd like to drop by the church and pick yours up, they will still be in the narthex or the lobby. Also a reminder that the July-August upper room is available, again found in the table in front of our beautiful cross window in the narthex. Well, that's all the announcements that I have. Please join with me in the call to worship. Though the mountains may shake,
we are standing on holy ground.
Though the earth moves under our feet,
Christ alone is our solid rock.
Though the walls may crack,
our refuge is in the everlasting love of God.
Though structures may come tumbling down,
God is our stronghold.
Though fear may seek to set up camp,
God is our strength and guide.
God, our Heavenly Father, regard with your loving kindness the homes of our country, that marriage may be held in high honor, and that husbands and wives may live together faithfully in honor, preferring one another. We pray that the members of every family may be rich in mutual understanding and forbearance, in courtesy and kindness, bearing one another's burdens, and so fulfilling the law of your blessed Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The scripture passages this morning have been chosen for Father's Day. The first comes from the book known as Ephesians. I'm reading in chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. Hear the word of the Lord. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise, that it may go well with you and that you may enjoy long life on the earth. Fathers, do not exasperate your children. Instead, bring them up in the training and instruction of the Lord. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. And now let us welcome the children for the children's sermon.
Everybody, my name is Armor Pam, and I'm welcoming all of you to Knights of North Castle VBS. And this is beginning on July 11th, running through Thursday the 15th, from 6 p.m. till 8:30. The castle doors will be wide open. Let's welcome our dragon friend, Sparky.
Hello, Armor. Ready for our noble adventure. Achoo!
Welcome, and wow, Sparky. What a way to catapult us into Knights of North Castle.
Thank you, Armor. We heard we were going on an adventure to the Knights of North Castle that involves a quest.
Right you are, Sparky. And while at Knights of North Castle, we will be in a quest for the king's armor. The castle is surrounded by snow and ice.
Achoo! What will we discover in our quest at Knights of North Castle?
Well, Sparky, on our quest, we will be in search of the Belt of Truth, the breastplate of justice, the shoes of peace, the shield of faith, and the helmet of salvation.
Well, sign me up. I'm ready for this quest. What else will we do at Knights of North Castle, Armor?
Oh, Sparky, there will be cool music, there will be exciting science, there will be creative crafts, and there will be fun recreation. But most of all, there will be memorable Bible stories.
Oh, tell me more so I can let all my dragon buddies know too. Shoot!
Whew! Okay. Well, how about this? During each session, we will discover a castle call out. So, when I say it, then Sparky, you repeat it. Armor up with truth.
Armor up with truth.
Armor up with justice.
Armor up with justice.
Armor up with peace.
Armor up with peace.
Armor up with faith.
Armor up with faith.
And armor up with salvation.
Armor up with salvation! Achoo. Ready to armor up, Armor.
Okay, why don't you plan on joining the Knights of North Castle? And again, we will open the castle doors wide open for you. That again is July 11th through July 15th, Sunday through Thursday evening from 6 p.m. to 8:30.
Armor up! Armor up! I'm ready to armor up at Knights of North Castle. See you later!
And we hope you will join us too.
Good morning, boys and girls. How are you today? Today is a special day, and I know that you know what it is. It's Father's Day. And this is a day to recognize and appreciate our dads for bringing us into the world and for all the good things that they have done for us. I have a couple of things that I brought with me this morning that remind me of my dad, and I wanted to share them with you. The first is bread. When we pray the Lord's Prayer, we pray, Father, give us our daily bread. I'm so glad that I grew up in a family where my father provided for our needs. Now, there's a lot of dads that don't do that for their family. Because my father provided for us, he was a hardworking man. He helped me to know that my Father in heaven, God, is a provider, and that God is trustworthy. So, bread, the first of my three words that begins with the letter B, reminds me that God is a good provider, and so is my dad. The second thing I brought with me today is a ball. My dad and I would go out in the backyard and we would toss a baseball. He taught me how to throw a football. This was the only ball that I had ready on hand. It's a dodgeball. But the purpose of sharing with you that Dad played ball with me is to let you know my dad took time for me. My dad taught me to be joyful and to have fun and to play. My dad helped me to know that being a Christian, it's okay to have fun. We can have a joy-filled life. You know, there's a lot of fathers who don't take time to play with their kids, who don't get down on the ground and wrestle and crawl and play with them, or who teach them how to shoot a basketball or whatever. Hopefully your dad plays with you. And the third thing that begins with a B is the word Bible. My dad gave me a Bible. My dad took me to church and taught me the importance of God's love and the stories of Jesus. And of all the things my dad did for me, perhaps introducing me to the Christian faith was one of the most important. So I hope that you'll remember my three B words: bread, ball, and Bible. And I pray that your dad is both a good provider and that he spends time with you and that he's teaching you about the Christian faith. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for our earthly fathers. Help us this day to show our love and our appreciation to our dads. And may we always remember to show our love for you, our Heavenly Father. Amen. Now be sure to wish your dad a very happy Father's Day. I'll see you next week. Bye now. The gospel lesson today comes from the gospel according to Matthew. I'm reading chapter 17, verses 19 through 21. When I read this, you may say, what does that have to do with Father's Day? And it may seem like an odd verse to read, but it pertains to my sermon title. The title of my sermon is called Changing the Face of Our Mountain. Listen for the word mountain in today's scripture. Then the disciples came to Jesus in private, and he asked, why couldn't we drive the demon out? And he replied, because you have so little faith. I tell you, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. He was on vacation, a visitor from the United States. That summer, he was hiking in the mountains of the Middle East. The land was barren, full of rocks and dirt and occasional spots of grass. As the visitor looked out across the valley, he saw a rather strange sight. What he saw was one of the village shepherds out walking around. The shepherd was an older man. He walked kind of slow. And every so often he would stop, he'd take his shepherd's staff and poke it into the ground. And then he would lift his gnarled hand and reach it into the bag that he had hung around his neck, and he'd pull something out and drop it into the hole. And then he would take his foot and shuffle some dirt across the hole. On he went, this old man, poking holes in the ground, reaching into his bag and dropping something into the hole, and then smoothing it over with his foot. The visitor from the United States thought this was an amazing sight. So he yelled across the valley, what are you doing? And the shepherd from the other side of the valley answered back, I'm changing the face of my mountain. The young man from the United States thought to himself, this old man is crazy. You can't change the face of a mountain. But he was curious, so he ran down the valley and then up the other side so he could get a closer look. Across the rock, the dirt, and the barren land, he ran. And when he got a little closer, he could see. He could see what the old man was doing. The shepherd would poke holes in the ground with his staff, reach into the bag that he had hung across his shoulder, and he was pulling out acorns. After gently dropping them into the hole, he covered it with dirt and stomped on it with his foot. Again, the visitor asked the shepherd, "What are you doing?" Again, the reply, "I'm changing the face of my mountain." You're crazy, said the impertinent young man. And on he ran, continuing his hike in the mountains. Well, years later, decades later, the young man had grown old. Late in life, he decided he wanted to make a return visit to the Middle East, where he had taken a vacation in his youth. He went back to where he thought the mountain was, where he had hiked. But he didn't recognize it. The mountain was not to be found as he remembered it. In its place was a forest of tall oak trees and a village of people living under its branches. There were children playing, adults working, all living on a new mountain. And at that moment, the American remembered the words of the old shepherd, how he had said, I'm changing the face of my mountain. Beloved in Christ, by using the gifts of love that God has given to each one of us, you and I can change the face of this mountain that we call America. Children remain the poorest age group in America, Nearly 1 in 6 lived in poverty just a few years ago in 2018. Nearly 11.9 million children. In 2017, there were approximately 674,000 maltreated children that we could substantiate here in the United States. That's a rate of 9 per 1,000. Now, legal definitions of child maltreatment can vary from state to state, but 4 types are generally recognized. There's physical abuse and sexual abuse. There's neglect, including educational and medical neglect, and there are other forms. And then there is emotional maltreatment. In the March edition of the American Journal of Medicine, a study found that between 1999 and 2017, nearly 39,000 gun-related deaths occurred among children and young people ages 5 to 18. Let me break it down by children and youth. That's 6,500 deaths among children aged 5 to 14. And nearly 32,500 among those in the age group 15 to 18. Now, among the causes of death, 61% were due to assault. A staggering 32%, though, to suicide. 5% were considered unintentional, and 2, it was undetermined. Friends, how can we change the face of this mountain we call America? On this Father's Day, I offer this solution. Take the unique gift of who you are and share it with a child. A number of years ago, we had a keynote speaker at our annual conference. Her name was Mary Taylor Prevete. And she held us spellbound with her stories. She has a fascinating background, which I won't take the time to tell you about. But at the time, Mary was the administrator of the Camden County Youth Center. She was working with troubled teens in one of the cities with the highest crime rate in America. Each day, she rubbed shoulders with youth from killer gangs with names like Lynch Mob and 8-Ball Posse. Mary had 3 points in her talk that she gave to us about how we can change the face of our mountain called America, and I'm going to share that with you in a minute. But I want to say this first. Her message is especially appropriate on Father's Day, but it's a message that we all need to hear. Every one of us has the potential to change the face of our mountain. We each have something unique about who we are. Maybe you can read, or you fish, or you can crochet. You can take that gift and share it with a child. This is how we will change the face of our mountain, one child at a time, just like one acorn at a time. As Mary visits with these troubled teens that are in her custody, she sits down and she listens to their stories. And after doing this for a number of years and hearing their heartbreaking stories, she says there are 3 things that the children and youth want us to know. 3 things that the children want us to hear. Do you want to hear what the kids want us to know? Number 1, spend time with me. Number 2, feed my spirit. And number 3, you are my role model. Let's look at each one of those. Number 1, spend time with me. Mary told us that many of our children and youth simply have no one who spends time with them, who listens to them, who cares about them. The children who end up in the juvenile detention center are telling Mary that there isn't anyone at home who listens to them, The kids are crying out, "Mommy, Daddy, spend time with me. Listen to me." Now, you know, if the parents aren't there for the children, do you know who will be? Mary says it's the gangs who step in and who take the place of parents. Kids will turn to drug dealers and pimps, and guess what? They listen to the children and they tell them, "You can be somebody. Come work for me." Drug dealers and pimps. How sad. The kids are crying out, "Dad, Mom, spend time with me. Ask me about my day. Ask me how I'm doing. Listen to the stories about what it's like for me growing up today." Many of the children report they have no memories of home. There's no family traditions, no celebration of holidays or birthdays, no family meals eaten together. Over and over again, she learned that children in America are living in houses, but not in homes. There are no memories being created. There are no traditions being passed on. And there is no one who will listen. The children and the youth today are crying out, "Spend time with me. Listen to me. Create memories for me." So, Dad, Mom, people of God, will we hear the children crying? The second point is this: feed my spirit. Miguel heard his father say over and over again, "You a problem to me. You nothing but a freeloader. You good for nothing. You gonna be nothing. You stupid." Miguel is now in the juvenile detention center because he believed his dad. Our guest speaker told a different story. When she was just a youth, her left hand was cut off in an accident involving a power saw. As she was recovering, her father pulled her aside and he said, "Mary, do you know what your brother said to me? He said he was sorry that you lost your hand, but he was wondering if he could have your bike, since you won't be riding it anymore." "But," his father continued, "you know what I told him? I told him not to get on that bike so fast, because Mary is going to ride it again." Mary, listen to me. The only handicap is the one in your mind. You can ride that bike or do anything else you want. Do you hear me, Mary? Mary now runs a detention center, and she has put down prison riots single-handedly because she believed her dad. Fathers, what message are you giving your children? Are you telling them that they're good for nothing, or that the only handicap there is the one in their mind? The children are crying out, "Feed my spirit." What messages will feed their souls? Do they know God loves them? Do they know we love them? Do they know that somebody loves them? Do we tell them that they matter, that their life is important? Do we tell them that we believe in them? The children cry out, "Feed my spirit." Finally, the third message we need to hear and remember from the children is this: you are my role model. You see, children learn by example. They're watching the adults around them, and they're learning by watching what the grown-ups do. Oh, the things our children are learning by watching us. They learn to smoke cigarettes by watching adults and doing drugs and drinking alcohol. They can learn how to work hard and save money and take care of their family by watching the adults around them or not. The children can learn to swear and cuss, or they can learn to pray and worship and praise God. You see, the children are watching us, not just the children we raise in our own family, but the children around us, the children who live in our neighborhoods, the children and the youth around our church, the children who see us in the store, and the ones who watch how we drive. Consciously or unconsciously, we are role models for the children. Fathers, your sons are watching you to learn what it means to be married to mommy. Do you treat her with respect and kindness, or do you abuse her with your language? Your son is listening. Dads, your sons are watching how you spend money, either selfishly or to help others. They're watching to see if you go to work or not. The children want, and the children need, good role models. One acorn at a time, the old shepherd planted oak trees. He probably never saw the forest, but he did change the face of his mountain. We too can change the face of our mountain called America. Listen to the children saying, "Spend time with me. Feed my spirit. You are my role model." May it be so. Amen.
While we do His good will, He abides.
do have a number of prayer concerns. Patty Lasher asked that we add her niece Sherry to our prayers. Sherry is having more medical issues related to cancer. And also, Patty has a friend, her name is Barb, who's having medical issues due to overwhelming stress, her grandson Isaac. So prayers for both Sherry and for Barb. Lord, hear our prayers. Prayer for Dr. Sion as he continues his recovery from COVID and lung transplants. Lord, hear our prayer. Alice Volentine asked that we place Richard Smith back on our prayer chain. Richard had a third stroke and was admitted to the hospital again. He's waiting results of blood work and CT scan and an MRI. For Richard Smith, Lord, hear our prayers. Richard and Dixie Lapidat asked for prayers for Sean Mahalik, who's in the hospital for an unknown reason. Sean is the son of a friend. Dorothy, also goes by Dottie Simalka, is in the hospital. She simply can't keep food down. Dottie is a friend from Triborough Senior Center. For these friends of the Lapidats, Lord, hear our prayers. Janice Wilbur has a praise. Her good friend, Brooksy Alberstadt, had surgery. It was successful, and she's now well enough to go to her daughter's house in Girard every other day. So we're very happy for Brooksy. Lord, hear our prayers. Pam Anthony, who works at the Tom Ridge Center part-time, bids us to pray for our former governor and first chief of Homeland Security, Tom Ridge. Mr. Ridge suffered a significant stroke and is in critical condition. Lord, hear our prayers. We want to pray for all the families of our church and friends of ours who have recently experienced the death of a loved one. We are praying particularly for the Burkhart and the Erickson families. Lord, hear our prayers. The preschool board continues to ask for prayers for a preschool director as well as for new admissions to the school. We're now up to 30, so we are very hopeful for the preschool and its reopening in September. Lord, hear our prayers. We had some good discussion at our church council meeting as we've talked about the children and youth who hang out under the portico of our church. And so I bid your prayers for our children and youth, especially the youth of this neighborhood. We do have a number of birthdays here at Lakewood. Please join with me in singing and wishing these persons a very happy birthday. Don Adams, Christine Kell, Kieran Wilkinson, Marty Blair, Judy Faustine, Sandy Whitford, and Caitlin Schmidt. Now, if you have any prayer requests or concerns, I ask that you hold that in mind and we will pray with you. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us go to God in prayer now. Holy God, from you we learn what a father is meant to be, strong, loving, and wise. And so for your sake, we honor those men who helped to give us life and who by their example have helped us to know you better. Thank you, God, for the men who cuddled and played with us and so helped us learn what your joyous love is like. Thank you for the men who were trustworthy and so taught us about your faithfulness. Thank you for the men who challenged us to make something of ourselves, who wouldn't let us keep crawling when they knew we could run. Thank you for the men who taught us how to play fair and the ones who encouraged us to do our very best. Thank you for the men who worked hard so that their children could enjoy a better life than they did growing up. Thank you for the men who showed us that gentleness is the proof of real strength. O God, our Heavenly Father, we pray for those men who have growing children. Give them the energy they need to keep up with the little ones. Grant them wisdom to guide the older ones. Give them patience in times of conflict, sensitivity in matters of the heart, and sound judgment in helping to prepare their children for the future. Help all dads to balance the enormous demands placed upon them, both at work and at home. O God, our relationships with our fathers are often complicated. Bring healing to those relationships where there has been hurt or disappointment or heartache. Help us to forgive our fathers for not being perfect. Enable us to forgive them when real injury has happened and we find it hard to forgive. And bless the memory of those dads who are no longer with us. O Father in heaven, we pray for children who do not know their father for one reason or another. Grant them the love they need. Bless, O Lord, all of our sick. Comfort those with chronic illness and heal those who recently had surgery. Bless all in the healing professions and all who care for the sick. And now, O God, we give this day back to you, asking your love and your presence in all that we do. We pray these things in Jesus' name. And as he taught us, we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
very happy Father's Day to all of our dads and to all of you. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide in your hearts this day and forevermore. Amen.